Hello everyone. We're going to make a birthday card today. This weekend, coming weekend, is my mother's birthday, and I was thinking about making birthday cards. So I want to show you some things that I made. This is the first one, and I made this one with one of Sizzix's new, I think it's pretty new, dies of a mason jar. And this one also, and probably for a limited time, includes the embossing folder for this jar. I think it's pretty cool. Do it this way. So what I did to make this card was I cut the jar out of an aqua color cardstock, and then I also cut it out of packaging. And then I embossed both of these with my embossing folder. And then what I did is I cut the rim part of the cap and the closure out of black cardstock. And then I used some bling and I mounted it on cardstock. And I used a stamp set that is made by Stephanie Bernard and of Stamps for Life, and this is the Be For Me stamp set. And I know that people don't collect bees in a jar, so I made mine sort of into lightning bugs, and it's not real lightning bugs, but work with me here. I used some gel pens and glitter pens, and use them on the wings and to outline. And then I used I used the Spice Marmalade Distress Marker to color in their bodies to look like fireflies. And then I stamped on the inside here. And I used again the Mixed Media by Colorbox by Donna Salazar in Jasmine. And I did a lot better this time. I didn't smear because I used less ink, because that's a very, very wet ink. Okay, so this is my card made with this Stamps for Life Stephanie Bernard stamp set and with Sizzix's Mason Jar die. Okay, and then next I made this card. And I used Tim Holtz's Mini Blueprints number 4. And I used the birthday card blueprints stamps. And I started with a white cardstock. And then I measured. And the stamps, to fit into a vignette this way, the stamps areas need to be 1 3/4 inches wide and 2.5 inches long, because that's the longest and widest part of each of these stamps. So what I did do is I took a piece of black cardstock and I measured my card and width and depth, and then did some math, to know that I had to put in, two and a half inch areas, and then dividing what was left over, and I made a window pane. And I'm not going to give you those measurements because they're going to be different for whatever size cardstock you use. And so then once I had my cutouts done for the window pane, then I mounted it on the cardstock, and then I stamped into my inserts. And then after that, I stamped all 4 stamps on a piece of white cardstock. And then I fussy cut around the cupcake and the hat and the gift and the balloon. And then I mounted them with pop dots. Well, before I mounted them on pop dots, I again colored with distress markers. And I used tumbled glass and milled lavender, wild honey, spice marmalade, Victorian velvet, spun sugar, bundled sage, antique linen, spice marmalade, and dried marigold to color in. And then I again used my colored glitter gel pens to embellish those popped up stamps. So you probably can't see that glitter, but it looks pretty cool in person. So then, you know, the inside is ready for whatever you want to do. So, and then to put my sentiments here, the happy birthday and the make-a-wish, I used Tim Holtz Simple Sayings, and those are two of the many. There's about 20 different sentiments on here, and I've used this quite a bit, and I really like it. I love the font, and I love the size, and there's just about something for everything on this stamp set. This is very well worth the money. And then also down here, there's an extra stamp for you can put a border, and then each of these stamps will fit inside that border. Okay, so this is a good buy. Okay, so let me move these out of the way. And on this stamp set where of the mini blueprints, you not only have the birthdays, but you also have the alarm clock and telephone, typewriter and fan, and then the mustache, pointing hand, ticket, and compass. Oh no, it's a game wheel. So this is also a very versatile stamp set. Get a lot of use out of that. So now we're going to come to this one. And this one I think is kind of my favorite because it just has so much punch. And it's a rectangle flip it. Again, I'm using Stephanie Bernard's Be For Me stamp set. And this time I used the Stephanie Bernard Die Flip It Card Rectangle by Sizzix again. And this is the way it comes. And what I'm going to do is make one with you. It's very simple, very easy. So first of all, I'm going to use an 8x10, 8.5x11, sorry, piece of cardstock. Let me grab my scissors next here. And you can probably get two of these out of the cardstock. Let me just cut this down. Okay, I'm going to fold it on that line and then I could cut it apart, but maybe I'll just make two while I'm at it, and then I won't have to cut it again for the next one. I'll have an extra one for the next time. Okay, so I'm going to pull my big kick over. First I'm going to make my sandwich. Okay. I'm going to run that through. And then I'm going to pull my cardstock off, and see, I got two out of that one 8.5x11 piece of cardstock. Move this out of the way also. Okay, I'm going to use one. And I'm going to take, first let me show you, there's a picture showing you. There's also, well, there isn't any picture on the back showing you, just how to cut it. So what we do is we put it in front of us with the edge that's cut with the thin line, and we will fold that this way on the crease lines, and then this way on those crease lines, and okay, there we go. I'm going to get it right side up for you. Okay, so let me pull that open again so that you understand what I did, because you probably couldn't really see that. So, taking this thigh edge with the the thin line, going to fold it back this way, and then fold this crease line this way, and then you have your card where it flips. Okay, so measuring, let me get my ruler. Let's do it this way. So this is 3 inches. So we want to cut this cardstock at, let's say, 2 3/4 inches. I'm sorry, 2 3/4 inches. And then this measures to 4 1/4 inches. So we're going to cut that in by 4 inches. So we've got 2 3/4 inches by 4. Okay, so I'm going to get my this out, and I'm going to measure 4 inches with my trimmer. Whoops. I'm going to do that. Okay, so we got 4 inches. I think I need a new blade. And by, what we say, 2 3/4. Okay, so we've got 4 inches by 2 3/4. I want to make sure I do that right. Okay. So now this is what we're going to stamp on. And I'm using Memento ink in Tuxedo Black. Bring my stamp set over. So first I'm going to start with my sentiment of just buzzing by to say, oh, I've got an errant little bee. So I'm going to put this on my stamp block. Ink it up with my Tuxedo Black ink. And we're going to start. I'm going to put that up here. Then, put that back on there. Oops. Put that back on there. And my next thing is the bee trail. And I'm going to bring out a little larger stamp block for that. Just gonna kind of manipulate this bee trail to fit on the stamp block. Put my ink on it. Then fit it to your paper. Press down, lift back up. Okay, got that done. Now I'm going to take a very small stamp block, and I'm going to use my two little bees, directional bees. I'm going to put one on each side of the stamp block. Okay, and put this one going this direction, and this one going this direction, and then my bee that's going straight ahead, I will put right here. Okay, so that's that side. Now we have another side to do. It's going to be the front of our card, and I'm going to use my adhesive and stick that on. Okay, got that. Now we need to do the other side. and grab my other piece of my paper, and we're going to again cut that to 4 inches. By 2 3/4. Okay. So let's pull this back out. So I think I've got my 4 inches. I do. And then we'll go to 2 3/4. Sure that I use the right piece. Here we go, 2 3/4. Okay, now I need to sharpen my blade. I need a sharper blade. So what I'm going to do is on these edges right here, I'm just going to sand them off a little bit. And what you can also do that I failed to do before attaching that one, you can also take your stamp pad and go along these edges and darken these edges. There's not a white core in this paper. It's the same color all the way through, but so it doesn't really matter, but it does kind of make a nice little frame. And if you are using paper that has a white core, then that gets rid of that white core. So that's really nice. Okay, so now I'm going to bring out my stamp set again, and find my happy birthday stamp. I've lost it. It fell off. I think it fell off the table. Yes, found it. Okay, so let's put it on my stamp block. It up in my Tuxedo Black Memento ink, and I'm going to have it right here on this edge. Then I'm going to take my larger B, ink it up, and put him right there. Okay. I didn't get the ink on there really good, so what I can do is I can go to my distress marker, or any marker, a Copic or any marker that you want to use. My distress markers are right here next to me, and just fill it in. It is a lot more accurate than trying to stamp that stamp on there again and get it right on it. So much better solution. Okay, so now let's go back to the B trail and I'm just going to be able to get a little bit of it in there this time because we have a lot more going on this edge. So let's just do that right there. Okay. And kind of trailed off a little bit, but I'll put a B there. Okay, so I'm going to take my little B's again and just stamp them here and there. Let's go with this one. And I've got one more that's flying around here somewhere. Okay. And let's put him right there. Okay. And then come back to our Flip It card with the adhesive on. Make sure you put this on right side up. Okay, then what I did for my card is I took two covered buttons and put them on the edges, but I also felt like it needed a little more, so I took some of the waste from my card and off that rough edge. Okay, so let's fix the edges. And then let's go over the edges with black. And then I just took my bee trail. And stamped it a little. There you go. On and off the edges. Took my little bees again. And stamped them here and there. On a little adhesive. Let's see, where do we do it? And let's put one here. And then you can embellish with your buttons. Okay, so I hope you had a good time making little cards with me. And I will see you next Monday. Bye.